Here's a little story. Let's say you're this kid from the Kasi, being forced to go to this all-boys school in the Western Cape. And for a long time, now I'm talking a long time, like many years, like just now, long time, you've been bullied by this pretty rich and pretty racist kid from the suburbs, and you've reported this to the prefects and teachers, and they've done basically fuck all. But there was always this one gent who wasn't a popular kid, who wasn't a prefect, but he was there, cheering you up on days when you were really low, buying you chappies. He was just there for you. Now one day, the bullying gets so bad that it goes public, and the whole world pressures the school into doing something about it. So the prefects and teachers, they actually get rid of the bully. But you know they never really cared. It was just something they had no choice but to do. But your friend that stuck by you all this time, even though he probably helped so you could just help him one day, he was there when no one else was. Okay, so let's say you're this kid, right? But you're actually the poor excuse of a governing party that is the ANC. For which, I'm very sorry. Ade. And let's say the teachers and prefects, they're the Western governments in the 80s and 90s. And your friend, well, he's the good old Soviet Union. You see that while the whole world deemed apartheid as something bad, which is actually an understatement, it took many years for anyone who had the power to help stop it actually did. Because, well, they were making money. But Russia was there helping the ANC when no one else was. And maybe it's because they weren't making money, but to the ANC, that part didn't really matter. So to these mabenas, I mean, ANC politicians, it's a no-brainer to at least lean towards supporting Russia in this Ukraine-Russia conflict. But they forget that what they do affects the entire country as a whole. Or they just don't really care, which is a lot worse. What they do and what they say and who they support affects her people, and not just them as a party. Mara, let's just try not to get bombed by the US, please. But I think we'll be fine, though. We're not Eastern enough for that. Well, false alarm. Now let's say you're this kid, right? And you now grow up to be even more powerful than the bully ever was. And you live a super happy, successful, rich life and have kids, say, I don't know, born free? Now you become so successful, in fact, that you completely forget about your children and start an affair with the guy who helped you in school. The South African people are your children. And you done forgot about us.